Hello friends, my name is Alex Krekus and I want to welcome you to the Finding Lost Civilization series. Today I'm trekking in Santa Barbara, California in search of ancient Chumash Indian cave paintings. I know today is going to be a fun journey and I invite you to come trek with me.
Mm-hmm.
Well, friends, I'm here trekking in the Santa Barbara foothills in search of Chumash pictographs. And I've arrived at this spot. If you look up over here, you can see a dry stream bed, an arroyo, so to speak. It's referred to as Arrowhead Springs or perhaps Salamander Springs. And it's called that because right above us, you can see a pictograph right there. And there appears to be a painting of a salamander or snake-like creature. I'll tell you, this is really fantastic, friends. Right over here to the left of the pictograph, right over here, you'll see a large boulder. And on top of that, there's about five or six mortars. So ancient life once existed here. Now, the fantastic thing about this pictograph is essentially that we're able to see it. It's on a sandstone boulder, and these eventually erode. It's not a good palette, so to speak, for paintings, because this stone, this rock, this boulder is very fragile, and eventually the painting will slough away. So, friends, we can consider ourselves very lucky to have seen this fantastic pictograph before us. So, here we begin our trek. Now, you'll hear gunfire in the background every now and then. Apparently, there's a firing range nearby this ancient site. But anyways, such is the new life. Well, here's our first challenge. I have to go down this, little gorge. I've got the camera in my hand, so I'll put it away, and hopefully I can make it to the bottom real easy here. As you can see, there's a lot of boulders here. Well, I made it down, and let me show you what it looks like from down on up over here. So, I had to shimmy down this rock right over here. So I started up there, and with both hands wedged myself into this area right here. But unfortunately, as soon as I came to the bottom, look at this human waste and trash, all this over here, pieces of broken bottle. Well, you can see that modern man has definitely been here. But anyways, we'll take our trek right here through this area. Looks like we'll have to break quite a bit of brush, but hopefully we'll be rewarded at the end. Well, there's a trail here and we're gonna follow it. Now, this is the first time I've been here, but luckily my friend Dave Landis knows this area and he's leading the way. It definitely is very beautiful and scenic. And in many ways desolate, but also in many ways signs of modern man is here. But look at this here. Okay, this is very interesting. Let's take a look to see if there's anything here. Well, let's investigate this site over here. This is really fantastic because it's a wall face, so to speak. So let's take a real close look to see if there was any signs of life over here. My goodness, look at this. This definitely could be ancient habitation shelter. Well, look at that right there in front of us. I'll tell you, to me, that does not look ancient. That looks like an effort by modern man to paint this here in this alcove, so to speak. Let's take a close look over here. No, I can tell you, friends, this is not an ancient Chumash painting, so to speak. Just by looking at the configuration of this painting, so to speak, this cave painting, I can tell that it looks like enamel type paint. And one of the ways you could tell is right at the end, as you can see kind of a plastic coating, so to speak, coming off of that. You see enamel has a plastic base. So let's get in real close and take another look at these so that we can differentiate the fake from the real. Okay, I'm in here real close, and this is what I'm talking about right over here. This is typical of enamel type paint. In other words, it's created a plastic barrier here, and you can actually see it. This is not an original Chumash cave painting, and neither is that one right here. And not only that, you can look at the styles and you can tell, no, this is not the real thing, so to speak. And then right over here is this other one. Again, that's a counterfeit, so to speak. But there's no doubt in my mind that ancient man actually probably used this site right over here. It's a really beautiful little shelter, so to speak. Well, as we're walking down this slope, certainly it looks like a trail. But actually, if you look right here to the right, you could see these rocks over here. During a rainy season, this is a stream bed. So this is a good place to habitate, so to speak, because you'll have access to water. Now the question is this permanent or temporary habitation? And if the water did not run here all year, sites around here are probably what I would consider temporary habitation shelters. Well, right over here, you can see that the stream is to our right. And what I'm going to do is go down in that area. So let's go explore it. This looks very promising over here. Have to be careful. It's somewhat steep. Now, one of the things that I recommend if you go on these treks is to bring a walking stick with you to help stabilize yourself as you're either going uphill or downhill. And especially if you're like me with a handheld camera in one hand, it's probably not the wisest thing to do. Well, here's the stream area again. Look at this here, a little waterfall area. So I'm gonna cross over right there. Well, if you look directly ahead, this is what I would consider a chaparral tunnel, so to speak. Could be a game trail, but I have to get down on my hands and knees and go through this tunnel onto the other side to see if we can find any signs of ancient life. So here I go. Friends, that's where I came down, right here. And crawl on my hands and knees half the way. And right over here, look at this. There's a small cave-like structure in there. One of the interesting things about this small little shelter here, so to speak, if you look at the entrance right over here, you can see these small indentations right over here. These are handholds, footholds, carved in here by the ancients to access this structure. Right over here, you can see one here, one right here, one right here, one here, right there, and of course another one here. So these handholds, these footholds, were put here by the ancients to access this small little shelter here. It's not big enough to stand in, so perhaps it had some ceremonial significance. But here's the inside of this alcove. It looks very dark now, but I definitely do see some pictographs in there. Right over here is that shelter area that had some pictographs in here. Now if you go to the right over here, there's a great alcove over here, an overhang, so to speak, and I see some pictographs right there in front of us. So let's go take a look. Look at this directly in front of us. You can see some symbols right over here all along. They're faded, but they're still there. So let's zoom in the lens. Let's take a look at these fantastic ancient Chumash pictographs.